Some movies are simple, and there's an attraction in that. Some movies, though, have something to say. They have layers of meaning, and when you get a layered movie that's interweaving those layers with subtlety, it can be an immensely satisfying experience. Windaria, on the other hand, is a movie that definitely has something to say and slaps you in the face with it over and over. That said, I do want to celebrate the fact that it has something to say. Windaria is a fantasy film from 1986 directed by Kunihiko Yuyama. These days, he's better known for being the primary director for the Pokemon franchise, that's right, both TV shows and movies. But before that, he worked on a huge variety of shows, from Mecha to Magical Girl to an anime adaptation of The Three Musketeers. Windaria is based on a fantasy novel by Keisuke Fujikawa, who also wrote the screenplay for the movie and is an accomplished anime writer of the 70s and 80s, working on Space Battleship Yamato, Galaxy Express 3-9s, Mazinger Z, God Mars, and Cat's Eye, plus a bunch of others. Windaria is also a classic fantasy story with a large cast of characters caught up in an epic moment in their history. Two nations are tilting towards war, one of them a peaceful, Greece-like seaside city-state, and the other a technological mountain kingdom. I don't think it's a spoiler to say that things don't go peacefully and a full Shakespearean tragedy unfolds in this formerly idyllic countryside of rolling hills and a massive, massive tree. The story initially centers on Isu, an impressively muscular farmer who eventually gets drawn into the conflict. And there's where my problems start, because the movie's only about 100 minutes long. There's not enough time to establish much depth of personality in any of its large cast of characters, like I said, Shakespearean. As a result, Isu is a simple-minded lunkhead who gets in over his lunkhead, and that's pretty much it. His wife is a long-suffering, sweet young woman, and that's pretty much it. Repeat for the rest of the cast. Now, this wouldn't be a problem if the film had an intricate plot, but now it's a war story between an otherwise idyllic, peaceful seaside country and a polluted, technology-obsessed military power. Pretty straightforward. Even that wouldn't be a problem if the film's themes and plot lines were intricately layered, but no, they're all laid out bare for you. There are a few thought-provoking moments and a couple of twists, but overall, the movie shoves its messages in your face with all the subtlety of a crowbar. That said, I have to admit there is a certain charm in a movie that is just so earnest about what it's trying to say, and that does come through in the film. And that is supported by its smooth animation, some of which is outright impressive even by modern standards. There's a great sequence partway through where a character, actually Isu, the main character, is getting used to driving a sort of hover bike, and the animation perfectly gets across the chaos of trying to control a finicky vehicle. It really works. Unfortunately, the art direction doesn't stand out much. It uses the same color palette as most anime of the 1980s. Now, that's not necessarily a complaint artistically. The characters feel iconic in a way, thanks to that more limited color palette, but overall, the visuals probably won't shock you, and as a result, the film's sequences can feel a little visually bland. There are a few moments of lovely character animation, but there's very little personality in any of the characters' movements either. Now, I listened to the Japanese dub of Windaria, which frankly didn't stick out to me. None of the voices particularly impressed me with any subtlety in acting, but none of them sounded annoying. In general, without getting into spoilers, Windaria is very much a product of its time, the earnest 1980s. It has a strong voice and a clear set of beliefs and definitely wants to be taken seriously, but it's just so forceful and melodramatic about it that it's difficult to take it as seriously as it appears to want to be taken. But hey, that is hardly the worst sin a film can commit. So if you're looking for a fantasy film with more to say than the average one, give Windaria a shot.